Happy Monday, ladies! It's Sylvia with Heavenly Makeup. I hope you had a fantastic weekend. Let me quickly share the post and we're gonna start. So today we will be talking about the shared... Okay. So today we will be talking about foundations, to find out what type of foundation is good for your skin, to find out how to correctly color match your skin to get to the right foundation. Hi Kasia, hi Paulina, hi Debbie, thank you for watching. So let's start with the type of foundations. So we have the powder foundations, we have the liquid foundations, we have the cream foundations, we have the BB creams. Now, depends on the type of your skin, you have to find the right foundation for you. So, for the dry skin, you always wanna look for something that will provide you that additional protection from the elements, from the air, and also will give you that additional moisturize. So, for dry skin, the best foundations will be BB cream. BB cream, it's a tinted moisturizer, which means it's a moisturizer with a color. And then the cream foundation. The cream foundation is pretty heavy, but it also gives you that beautiful additional like layer of moisture to your skin, protects your skin from the air, from the heat. It really will protect your skin from over drying. And BB cream gives you very light coverage, while the cream foundation will give you full coverage. So depends what coverage you're looking for. You either want to go with BB cream or with the cream foundation. For normal skin, the best is the liquid foundation. So this is the normal skin, this is the combination skin, but not on the oily side, like dry to normal, normal, normal to combination. I would not recommend the liquid foundation for like very oily skin. For oily skin, we really are going with the powder foundations. So this one, it's good, like I said, for normal, dry to normal skin. It's gonna give you moderate coverage. The good thing about this liquid foundation is it's buildable, which means you're gonna, if you apply more, you're gonna get better coverage. So if you wanna better coverage, but you have like normal skin, you don't wanna go with that cream foundation, which may be a little bit too heavy for normal skin, that's when you're gonna go with the liquid foundation. And then for oily skin, you wanna go with the powder foundation. So powder foundation, you can pick either pressed powder, which is my favorite because for me it's the easiest to use, or you're gonna go with the loose powder foundation. And now I broke it. So you can have the loose powder foundation or the pressed powder foundation. The difference is the loose powder foundation will give you better coverage. The pressed powder, it's a little bit less coverage. You have to use like more product to get a good coverage. So why you wanna use for the powder foundation for your oily skin? The powder will absorb the oiliness from your skin. So if you're gonna go with any of the cream foundations, if you are really on the oily side, like I am on very oily side of the skin, plus I live in California, dry air, very hot, which makes your skin produce more oil, that's why I'm going with the powder foundations. It really absorbs the oiliness. It's also important to have the good moisturizer. So if you have oily skin, you wanna have the moisturizer for the oily skin. Because if you're gonna go without any moisturizer, if you're gonna go with the moisturizer for wrong type of the skin, your skin will try to balance it. So if you have oily skin and you're gonna go with moisturizer that is not good for your skin, then your skin's gonna try to balance it. If you're gonna go without any moisturizer, it's gonna say, okay, I'm right now over dry, so I'm gonna produce even more oil than normally do. So that's why it's important to have a good moisturizer as a base before you're gonna put the product. Another thing I wanna talk to you about is to find the right color of foundation. First, you need at least two colors during the year. During summer, when you are tan, you need a darker color, and during winter, when you are losing your natural tan, you want a lighter color. And depends where you live, depends like which part you're living. So in some in some parts of the states right now, it's already getting cold and rainy, so you have way less sun than in the south part. Like in here in California, we are still having 80s, and I dream for just 70s. So we are still having lots of sun, so I'm still tanning, while in the north side, you are already have way less sun. So your skin is slowly getting lighter. So for winter, you always wanna have a lighter foundation than for summer. And usually the months between, you will be using two and you will be mixing them. And that's fine, that's normal. That's what I'm doing too during that transition period. Another thing, we have, our skin has different undertones. So you can have a cold undertone, you can have the warm undertone, or you can have the neutral. The difference is, the easiest way to find out the difference truly is, depends how you're tanning. So if your skin is always tanning right away brown, you're not burning, you have that yellow undertone in your skin, so your skin is in that warm game of the colors. While if you are burning very quickly, your face is getting red right away with little exposure to the sun, you are on the cold side on that red undertones. So it's important when you go to the store to know what family of the undertones you're looking your foundation in. The main mistake I am seeing is when you go to Ulta or some other store when you wanna buy a foundation, and they're gonna tell you to try the foundation on your hand. Really? Is the color of my hand the same as the color of my face? No, it never will be. Simply because your hands are the most exposed to the sun. So your hands are always gonna be the darkest. So if you're gonna try the foundation on your hand and you're gonna go home and you're gonna take that foundation, put it in your face, it will never ever work for you. The best way is if you can get some samples and try them at home on a clean skin, no makeup at all on your skin. Try it in the morning in front of the window with no sun going on your skin. So like right now, I'm sitting in front of my window. This is the east side, which means I have daylight, but I don't have direct sun on my face. So that's the best time when I can try some foundation. You wanna apply it to your face and you wanna wait a little. So you don't wanna like apply it and it's like, okay, this color works for me. The foundation, especially the liquid foundation, needs time. It's gonna work with the air, it's gonna work with the oxygen, and the color in the next minute or two will slightly change. So you wanna wait 2-3 minutes, and that's when you're gonna decide which color is good for you. And you always wanna try 2-3 colors to find out the one that is matching your skin the best. Also, if your face is tanned, you have to remember that your neck, it's practically never ever tanned. Because when you are walking, you are always covering it. When you have long hair, your hair is covering it. So you may also wanna try not only on your cheek, but also on your neck to find out how that will work. Because when you are applying your foundation, you're not stopping here. You're always going down, so you don't have that line. So you wanna make sure that it's not gonna look very weird on your neck because it's gonna be much darker. So if your face is a little bit more tanned than your neck and it's really visible, you wanna go maybe with foundation that is slightly lighter on your face, but it's gonna be darker on your neck. So it's gonna even out those colors. What else I wanna talk about? So we talked about the types of foundations based on the skin type. We talked about the undertones of your skin, which is very important to know your undertone when you're picking the color, and trying the foundation preferably at home, in front of the window, in front of the daylight, not outside, not in the sun, but in front of the daylight. And like I said, apply it to your face, wait a little, and that's when you're gonna decide on the right color. So I think that's all for today's session. How are you doing that, Agata? That's weird. So tomorrow we will be talking about the setting products, about the concealer, the primers, the importance of it, and how to apply it, how to use them. If you ladies have any questions, if you ladies wanna me help you with color coding, color matching your skin with the foundation, please either comment in the video or message me and I will get back to you. I have a nice online test that you can quickly take and find out the first of all if you are in the cold or the warm family of the colors, or maybe you are neutral, because you kinda like me, I'm usually tanning very well, except my face sometimes gets burned, so I have to be like I have to be really careful when I'm outside with my face. Hi Eva. So that's all for today, ladies. Thank you so much for watching. Please share with your friends if you think that will be useful for them, or invite them to my VIP group so they don't miss any of my videos. If you wanna be notified about my videos, please send me a message. This week until Friday, we will be talking all about face. So we talked about the foundations. Tomorrow, like I said, we will be talking about the setting products, the primer, the concealer. We also will be talking about the blushers, the luminizers, highlighters, bronzers, and then we also gonna talk about how to apply it. We also gonna talk about contouring. I know many women are kinda, I don't wanna do it, it's too much work. It's really depends what product you're using. It may be lots of work, but it also may be very quick and easy to do. So we will be talking about all of that until Friday. Friday will be the last day. I am targeting the videos for 7 p.m. Pacific time. But it may slightly change, depends how everything will go at my home. So like I said, if you want me to set up the reminders for you so you always know what time I'm doing the videos, let me know and I will set up the reminders. Thank you so much for watching and talk to you tomorrow. Bye ladies!